Well, Julia Gillard has made it clear today she doesn't think anyone should be playing politics with the devastating news from Ford. But Tony Abbott is blaming the carbon tax for putting the handbrake on the car industry. Political editor Hugh Rimmington reports from Canberra.
In the past dozen years, taxpayers have heaved over $1 billion at Ford. So how was that not enough?
It's not easy days in manufacturing.
The opposition sees the carbon tax.
Anything that adds to the cost of manufacturing in Australia is something that we don't need at a time like this, and the carbon tax is one of those things.
Less than 2 years ago, Ford's Bob Graziano warned climate change policy will impact key commodities. Any price changes will find their way along our supply chain. But today, this.
There are a number of costs, and it's not just that cost.
The opposition says the carbon tax adds $400 to every new vehicle. The industry puts it at less than half that. It can't explain why Fords built here are four times more costly than those produced in Asia. The government blames
the strength of the Australian dollar,
the weight of the Australian dollar,
the high Australian dollar,
a persistently high Australian dollar.
We've been buying fewer Fords. The Falcon is no longer loved. Low volumes, says the government, hit economies of scale.
There will be a better tomorrow.
The federal opposition had been seriously considering cutting taxpayer subsidies to the car industry, a factor one senior Labor figure says might have prompted Ford's announcement today. The Prime Minister, though, says this is not a day for politics.
This is too serious and hard a day for too many people, for people to play silly games about it. I think that'll just turn people's stomachs.
Tonight, too many stomachs are churning already. Hugh Rimmington, 10 News.